So as I was asking you, what is your assessment of these students here? I know you volunteer your time, but what are you feeling from them?
I see a lot of energy. I see a lot of passion. They know what they want to do. And these students, well, what they need is the resources to continue moving them to that passion. That's one. Then number two, they need the knowledge. Because you can have passion and resources and keep on moving, but there's no knowledge. They might be moving towards the wrong thing. One thing I like about AI, it holds every field. What I mean holds, it pulls in every field into it. So in this class, we have architects. We have people who have degrees in math and operational research. We have just ordinary housewives who just woke up this morning and said, I really want to go learn something. And at the end of the day, we notice that she's going to be giving into the community. She'll be giving her time. We have teachers, Montessorian teachers, which I'm very proud of. I knew of Sadiq, who comes from, has an independent consulting business into petroleum. There's an architect, Mr. B is an architect. There's also a microbiologist. And as of this morning, the National Association of Fisheries sent two delegates from the Fisheries Department. And as a matter of fact, artificial intelligence has to do with mimicking life, mimicking intelligence in life to solve our own problems. One of our techniques has to do with swamp particle. Swamp particle is mimicking a school of fishes. How do they have to do it? If fishes can do it and solve their own problems, how come we humans can do it? We have tools like ant colonies, genetic algorithms, neural networks that mimics our nervous system. All these are solutions, creative solutions to solving creative problems. This new generation or future generation, I feel, can do it. They have the inspiration, they have... As a matter of fact, they didn't want to take a break. They said, we want more. We want to learn more. And I believe that the more they learn, the more they can solve this problem.
Thank you. So I've been speaking with my colleague and sister here, Oluwato... Please don't kill me. Oluwato Singh.
My name is Olatoyosi.
Olatoyosi.
Oludeafolabi.
Olatoyosi, Oludeafolabi. I have to get this straight. And I know what's responsible for the... Anyhow. So what would you say to Nigerians in the diaspora, not Nigerians in the diaspora, who are into volunteerism, who understands that when you give back is the best way to actually be a human being on this planet, in my view, for our sisters and brothers, our colleagues in the diaspora that we've been knocking on their doors asking them to support the initiative, what can you say to them to really come and support?
As a professor teaching students in the America, I've seen American students, and I see our children, they're more smarter than American students. They only have one brain and one body. Just the same way as these American students. Yet, they have the best solutions. I implore everybody to support them, to look at them as a new generation of creative solution providers. Anyhow, you can, just a little bit. I mean, if you have just a little money, for example, I'm so happy that we have a solar panel, but I'm very sure that a more creative solar panel can be also invented by this new generation. They're very energetic. All they need is just a little push. If my daughter at 14, who just turned 15, can have 7 engineering awards building a robotic trash sorter, I believe anybody can do it. She just turned 15 this year. But last year, she got 7 engineering awards building such a thing. She doesn't even have a college degree yet. Now imagine what this new generation can do. They can do more.
Thank you so much. I really appreciate you, and I thank you for doing this. Okay?
Yeah, appreciate
See you soon.
Bye. Bye.